Hi, it's Chef from DwyerOmega. We get a lot of questions about different wire configurations for our CNPT series controllers. And in this video, we're going to configure this CNPT for PID control using a DC control solid state relay. So stick around because we're going to break it down for you right here. The Omega CNPT Platinum Series microprocessor-based PID controllers offers unparalleled flexibility in process measurement and control. We've already covered wiring for a mechanical relay using on-off control in a video linked somewhere up here. But for better control of your set point, we're going to be using the CN16DPT304 with a DC pulse output, and we're going to program this unit for PID control. For this demonstration, we'll be using a SA1-T thermocouple probe, SSRL240 DC controlled AC load solid state relay, a fuse and a fuse block, hookup wire, a terminal block, an AC power cord with stripped ends, a KHA flexible heater, and of course, here's our CN16DPT304 PID controller. We've put the links in the description for all these products so you can find them on DwyerOmega.com. First, we'll wire in the AC power input to the terminal block. Then I'll attach the lead wires to the terminal block and attach the line and neutral wires on the CNPT respectively. Now let's connect terminal 2 to terminal 3 on the solid state relay, and also connect terminal 1 to terminal 4. This completes the DC control signal from the controller to the SSR. And now connect terminal 8 to one side of the fuse block, then the remaining side to terminal 2 on the solid state relay. And now we'll connect one lead wire from the heater to terminal 1 on the load side. Here we're going to connect the remaining lead wire to the neutral connection on the terminal block to complete the circuit. We will now connect the thermocouple to terminal 2 and 3 on the input terminals on the CNPT. Finally, we'll plug in our power cord. And now we'll program the CNPT.
I'm going to press the up arrow once, it goes to run. And then I'm going to press it again, it goes to operation. Then I'm gonna hit the right arrow one time to go to the initialization menu. I'm gonna hit enter initialization. It says input. I'm gonna hit the enter key one time to go to input. And I want TC. It's already on TC by default. So I'm gonna press the enter key again. And I'm gonna select type T because I'm using a type T thermocouple. Pressing the right arrow two times. Hitting enter again to select type T, it goes back to TC. Now I'm gonna press the up arrow to go back to input. Now I'm gonna press the right arrow one time to go to reading to set up the annunciator. I hit enter on reading and hit the right arrow once, twice, three times, four times to annunciator one. Now I'm gonna press the enter key one time and I'm gonna select DC1 since that's the output we're using, pressing the right arrow once, twice, three times. Then I'm gonna hit enter to make my selection on DC1. It goes back to annunciator one. And now I'm gonna press the up arrow once, twice, to go back to initialization. Now we need to program the set point. So I'm gonna press the right arrow, go to program, and I'm gonna press the enter key one time to go to set point one. Now I'm gonna select set point one by pressing the enter key. And now I'm gonna press the left arrow because I want a set point of 100. I use the left arrow to move the digit, right arrow to change the digit. So I'm gonna change that to 100.0, and now I'm gonna hit enter to store that. Now I'm gonna hit the right arrow once, twice, three times, four times, five times to go to DC1 to set that for PID. So I hit enter, it says mode, and then I press the enter key again, it says off, that means output's off, and I'm pressing right arrow one time and it says PID. Now I press enter to select that, and now it says action. I hit enter on action, and for heating, I want reverse action. So it's already defaulted, so I hit enter again to select that. So now I'm gonna press the up arrow once, twice, three times to get out of DC1, and now press the right arrow one time to get to PID. This is where we're gonna set up the autotune. I hit enter on PID, it says action. I've already set that previously, and hit the right arrow once, twice to tune. Now I hit enter on tune, it says start, and now I hit enter on start to start the autotune.
As you can see, the autotune has started to find the correct P, I, and D values to provide the most accurate control. Once it says done, the Annunciator light is synchronized with the indicator light on the relay, cycling the power to the heater to accurately maintain the set point.
So there you have it. We've wired the CNPT controller and configured it to run using PID control. If you need more information about PID control or Omega's Platinum Series controllers, contact one of our engineering experts at DwyerOmega.com. Thanks for watching and be sure to like and subscribe.